The Philippine Justice Department says Manila's request for extradition of former Negros Oriental Representative Arnolfo Teves Jr. is now up to the hands of the Court of Appeals in Timor-Leste. Assistant Secretary Mico Clavano said they hope to receive the decision of the appellate court within the next few weeks. A red notice from the Interpol for the arrest of Teves was received by the government of Timor-Leste in February. Teves was arrested in March by the Timorese police. He is currently in pretrial detention at the Bacora prison. The former lawmaker is facing multiple murder charges in the Philippines for the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo and 9 others.
Pumasa na po sa first screening na yun sa Ministry of Justice. At yung Ministry of Justice na mismo sa Timor-Leste ang nag-forward sa ating request sa Court of Appeals. Doon po magkakaroon ng decision whether to deport, extradite, or transfer former Congressman Teves back to the Philippines.
Philippine authorities preparing to press charges against the suspect in a shooting at the EDSA Ayala Tunnel Tuesday. PNP spokesperson Colonel Jean Fajardo says they are preparing to file murder charges as well as violation of the comprehensive firearms law and traffic rules. Fajardo says the Mercedes-Benz the suspect drove had a different plate number when it was recovered from the suspect's home in Pasig City Wednesday. Makati City Police say they could file the cases by Friday morning. The Land Transport Office also issuing a 90-day preventive suspension of the suspect's driver's license. The LTO says it has filed administrative cases against the suspect, such as reckless driving and improper person to operate a vehicle.
Another kaso po na po pwedeng isampa po ay yung pong violation po ng Republic Act 10591 kung saan nahulihan po siya obviously yung baril po na nakarehistro sa kanyang pangalan ay bit-bit po niya during the time ng incident at nagamit po yon sa pamamaril at malinaw po doon sa provision po ng 10591 in the absence of a permit to carry na lisensya po ay hindi po pwedeng dalhin ng sino man kahit meron po siyang LTAP at nakarehistro po yung kanyang baril.
Over a dozen Hong Kong pro-democracy activists found guilty in a landmark subversion trial. 14 activists were convicted while 2 were acquitted in Hong Kong's biggest trial against the democratic opposition. They were charged with conspiracy to commit subversion under the national security law imposed by China. They are part of 47 defendants arrested in mass dawn raids across the city in 2021. The rest pleaded guilty during the prosecution process, avoiding trial. The sentence for the convicted activists will be handed on the later date.
Because right now, there's not much press freedom, not much freedom of expression, and no freedom of assembly, and no freedom of demonstration. People are very frightened. I don't think many people dare to talk to you. So Hong Kong was not like that a few years ago. So we have to go back to those days. And the economy of Hong Kong is in deep trouble. If you walk around the city, you see so many empty shops. So we have to do something to revive the economy, to revive the city's vibrancy. And one thing we need is for the people to be free, to be safe.